Good evening. God bless each and every one. Thank you for tuning in to Thursday Night Music Mix on the best gospel, the best praise talk show in America, the TMA Radio Broadcast. I'm your host, Pastor Ackridge, and we about to kick it in full gear on this Music Mix Thursday. Hey, man, the time is 36 minutes past the hour, and we are going to be tuning in to, hey, man, Prophetess Tina Talley, her interview with Pastor Carl Ackridge on the Women's Conference that's coming up this weekend, Friday and Saturday at 7 o'clock. So I want you to stay tuned, and we'll be kicking in just a minute. See what them young, powerful women of God talking about. So continue to listen to Music Mix Thursday on the best station it is in North Carolina, the TMA Radio Broadcast.
Lord, we thank you. thank you. We're going to praise you. Yes, Jesus. For all your goodness unto us, O Lord. For your mercy every day. Somebody to sing it with me, just say it.
Lord, we love you. We love you, Jesus.
After everything you've done, we come back to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You are good. And we lift our voice and fill the air.
Let's go to our weather forecast. Hey man, tonight we're looking at a low of 30 degrees. Friday, mostly sunny, high of 54 with a low of 31. Saturday, scattered showers, high of 49 with a low of 33. 60% chance of rain. Sunday, partly cloudy, high of 47 with a low of 30. Monday, high of 52 degrees with a low of 29. Tuesday, mostly sunny, high of 55 with a low of 34. Wednesday, amen, Wednesday, high of 62 with a low of 49. And then Thursday, partly cloudy, high of 69 with a low of 53. And that's your 7-day forecast. Amen.
About searching for the
I wanna know how you feel. I wanna know, do we got something real? I'm searching for a purpose to love. That pretty smile on your face, I caught a case of your love. I know how to treat you, I know how to please you. Even when you act shy, I still know how to see you. Cause I'm searching day and night, trying to get it right. Searching day and night, trying to get it right. Searching, 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 searching for you. Searching, 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 searching for you. I'm searching for this vibe, I'm searching for that high. Let me find the truth, let me look you in the eye. Girl, don't ever, ever tell me lies. If you mess up, don't even hide. Searching, 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 searching for you. Searching, 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 searching for you.
I think she's getting it wrong. There she is.
We had to try another option. We had to turn off the computer and use the iPhone. So.
Oh, that's what it was. Yes, yes. You can't do it on the... you have to be an iPhone user. Come on. So that's what it was. We have some guests.
Yes, I was trying to use the computer. So it wouldn't allow me to use the computer, but we got another option.
Yes, isn't it good to have devices, different options? You know, when the devil tries to act crazy, we gotta come around another way. Say another way.
Another way.
Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. Good evening, everybody. Those that are coming in, I want you to share this broadcast. Amen. I want to welcome some people. Hey, Minister Robin. Hey, Sister Lisa Manning. Hey, my brother Tony. Tony, we're going to see you tomorrow night. Hey, my girlfriend Felicia Suggs. Glory to God. And Michelle Henry, God bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Those that are coming in, I welcome you tonight. Vanetta Shepherd, we welcome you. Bernita Ewing, God bless you, my friend in Cleveland. Janet Morris, I bless you this evening. Hi, honey. Thank you for joining us. How you doing, Pastor Barb Andrews? God bless you, Sharonda. Amen. Bless you, Pastor Dennis Lambert. Bless you. I want to welcome you all to our Facebook Live this evening. I wanted to jump on this evening, amen, and talk about the conference that will be going forward as of starting on tomorrow evening in Lewisburg, North Carolina. Amen. It's going to be epic. Amen. It's a women's conference, but we're asking that men, they are allowed to come. Amen. It's going to be a place, amen, and a wonderful and get a fresh word from the Lord. I'm excited. Amen. I want to her conference, one of my spiritual daughters, and we are getting ready to turn Lewisburg upside down. Amen. So you all greet her with some wonderful hearts. Amen. Give us some hearts and some thumbs up. If you can all hear us real well, please give us some thumbs up and give us some hearts. Amen. And let us know that you are welcoming my guest. Amen. Thank you for those wonderful hearts. Go ahead, Pastor Carol. Amen. Tell them a little bit about why the Lord has called this conference. Amen. And just tell us a little bit about you and then the conference. Amen.
First, I want to start off a little about me. We've been in ministry for a year and a half out of Lewisburg College, 845 service. Me and my husband, Healing Word Ministry. We decided to do this women's conference because women are in need. Mm-hmm. Women are going through a lot of things. So we decided a year ago to plan a conference. And the thing we decided to come up with was deliverance.
Amen.
Because a lot of people say set free, but I'm going to use deliver because a lot of people need to be delivered from all of their problems. A lot of other people... other churches, you might hear them say set free, but like I said, we have a lot of women that are struggling, and I know we saw in the news today, in Raleigh, I know you heard about the young mother, 20 years ago, gave her child marijuana, and young kids, our society that we're living in today where kids are young mothers don't even know how to raise their babies, losing their babies, and she might not ever get that child back again.
Maybe. That's a very good possibility.
Yeah. So see, drug addictions, we have so many young ones that are out on drugs, mothers on drugs, like we said, losing their young ones. Kids are going in young directions. We have so many women that are giving themselves up freely. Mm-hmm. And like I like to talk about, like, women giving themselves up sexually, they're allowing different spirits to enter into their bodies.
Mm.
And they're wondering why it's like a cycle. And also, we want all these chains to be broken. Generations to be broken. Just because grandmother did it, grandpa did it, it doesn't mean that the cycle is going to end somewhere.
Yes.
So we're just looking for a good time. Being delivered, women being delivered are all things. Even just learning God, to come closer to God, because a lot of people, they don't really know God.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people need to be delivered of a lot of issues. Marital problems.
Yes.
Divorces. If you go on, the list goes on and on.
Yes, it does.
Domestic violence.
Yes.
So we just want to touch different women of all races, all issues. We just want to be there to pray for you, talk to you.
Yes.
And most of all, to let you be set free, delivered of all of these issues that you're going through. But it has to start somewhere. You have to be willing to end the cycle.
That's
you got to be willing continue, not just come to the service. We want you, even after the service, to continue to pray, continue to get close to God. Find a good base church.
Mm-hmm.
We have the church in Durham, Power to Reign, if you're in the Durham area, Lewisburg, we have Healing Word Ministry. We just have different churches. If you don't have a church home, we're just looking for you to come out, continue to be delivered, continue to live, to be set free. And those are mostly the things that at this conference that we'll want to have you come out for.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And with that situation with that young mother, if somebody could have just ministered to her, if somebody could have just been able to reach out to her, or if she would have had the strength to reach out to somebody and say, I'm in need, I need help, I need someone to pray with me, I need somebody to teach me how to parent.
Yes.
You know, and I believe that right now we are lacking mentorship. We are lacking someone to cover our women and to help them become mothers and to help these babies who have had babies while they're babies, to teach them,
yeah,
you know what, how to love their children. Oh, when I saw that, I thought, oh my God, she could not have possibly done such a thing. But it was true. It was true.
Yeah.
That she would allow not her child just to smoke a cigarette, but to take a hit off of a joint. And
yes,
I'm saying, Lord Jesus, help God, help now. There needs some assistance now to these young mothers that are out here. And mothers, period. How about that? Let's talk about that now.
Yes.
What about just deliverance? Just yes, empowerment, just letting them know that we love them in spite of what their upbringing was.
Yes. And a lot of these mothers, young mothers, they're afraid. They don't know where to turn to. They really don't have anyone to talk to because, like you said, a lot of young mothers are having young mothers. You have mothers that are out here that want to hang out just like their daughters, party and club.
Mm-hmm.
So
now you're saying something right there. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So when they see their mother do that, they think it's a cycle. Well, this is what I'm going to do and get high, and this is what I'm going to do just like my mother did. So it's cool, but it's not cool when it comes to the last moment, because that could have been prevented for the young child.
Yes.
And now she has to think about it.
Mm.
And not with that, I was looking, like I said, I just hate turning on the news galore. It's always something. It was a mother, I'm not sure what state it was, her and her boyfriend killed a 4-year-old baby.
Jesus. Oh yeah, I did see that. Yes.
Yes. And so that's what I'm saying. Mothers, these young mothers, they need help. These young women today need help. They need to be delivered. Because we see it right around in our local area. Raleigh's only 30 minutes from here. I know it's probably, 15 from Durham. It's everywhere.
Yes, yes. So, and if we don't, as pastors, make a stand for our communities and for the women and men and also girls and boys, if we don't make a stand for them, then they're going to allow, you know, gangs to impart to them, you know, different things that are out here in this world that the enemy is really trying to take them out. And it is happening every day. Oh, I have a pastor, Lambert, saying that was my cousin and her husband. Oh, my God.
Oh, wow.
Well, Pastor Lambert, we're going to be praying definitely for, we're going to be definitely praying for that, your family. We definitely want that to, you to know that we're holding your family up in prayer. I guess he was saying that the couple that killed, Pastor Lambert, would you come back on and let us know if that was the couple that killed the four-year-old? Was that your family members that you just said that was your family? Because that breaks my heart. I'm not sure if that happened in North Carolina, but yes, it was a terrible thing. I do believe that they struck the child, correct?
Yes.
He said that. He said, yes, that was his family. I believe that the child was hit. We're going to pray for your family. We're going to pray for them before. Matter of fact, let's just stop now. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you right now. We come, first of all, thanking you for who you are, Lord. And right now, I pray for Pastor Lambert's family, God. I pray for the young man and the young woman that were the parents of this four-year-old child that was found beaten and dead. Oh, God, we're just covering them right now, Lord, covering the mother, covering the father, covering the family, God. I my heart breaks right now that they could endure something like this, Father. I'm not sure how the enemy came in, but we know that it was the plot and a plan of the enemy. I pray, God, salvation now. Yes, God, I pray salvation now for the mother and for the father. You already have the baby, God. You already have the baby wrapped up in your arms, Lord. But God, I pray, Father, that somebody would give them Jesus. Yes, God. Somebody would give them Jesus, and that they would repent for their sins, God. They will have to pay the price for their sins, God. But Lord, let them repent for them and let them be saved and let their minds be changed, God. Father, while they're in prison or in jail, Lord, we call that your angels of protection will be around them. Don't let them take their life. Suicide is not an option, God. We ask that you would guard them while they're in there in the name of Jesus, Lord. Just, Father, send your help in the name of Jesus. Send your help to every teenage mother, every young father in the name of Jesus. Lord, we're asking you this. Father, we're asking that this conference will be a mark in North Carolina like never before. We're praising you now, God, for opportunity to minister to your people, God, to the ones that are hurting, to the ones that are in pain, to the ones that are carrying hidden pain. Father, for the ones that know that they don't even have, Father, a hope. They think that they don't have a hope, but God, we want to throw them a lifeline on tomorrow night and on this weekend and on Saturday. Lord, we thank you for being God. We thank you, oh God, for being a healer. We thank you for being the deliverer. In Jesus' name, amen. Those that are just coming on, we want you to be invited for tomorrow night. I will be the guest speaker for the Healing Word Women's Conference there in Lewisburg, North Carolina. I just pinned the address and information at the bottom of the Facebook live feed, amen. It will be held at Free Salvation Church, 419 Fox Park Road in Lewisburg, North Carolina, at 7 p.m. This is my guest, amen, my daughter, who is the founder of this women's conference and this women's movement for Healing Word Ministries, amen. And so we're just chatting a little bit about what is going on in society right now with women, amen, with hurting women, with, let's just say hurting women. And then there are some, I did a Facebook Live and a Periscope last week, I think it was Friday night, about hidden pain. Let's talk about hidden pain, because I know that there are so many women and men right now that are going through some things in their life, and women that are hiding. We hide things real well. We hide things real well. And I think that this is an hour for us to come out and address those issues. Why don't we just talk a little bit about that?
They're hiding their pain. They're hiding their abuse today. Some women, they're going through some things at home, which when we look at them on the outside, or when we go to work and we see these women, we think that everything is fine. Everything is not fine, because some of these women, they're being abused at home. They're going through domestic violence, and they are ashamed.
Yes.
And them being ashamed of going through this domestic violence, they're not going to reach out to anyone, because at the end of the day, they think that the man loves them. Mm-hmm. They're trying to hold on to all of his excuses of why he's doing it. They make up an excuse. And not only with that, hidden pains, we got women that's holding pains from things that happened. They could have been raped by someone in the family a long time ago. And they don't hear all the pain. Nobody knows about it. They didn't tell anybody about it. And back then, you probably had grandma say, it's okay, long as nobody know. And they never told anybody.
Right.
But now it's time to release all of these pains. It's time to confront. Because we got to know that God is a loving God.
Yes.
God forgives.
Yes.
It doesn't matter what.
Yes.
God, he cares for us. And
yes, he does.
You have to know that no matter what, how it looks, it's nothing wrong with releasing your pain, crying out to God.
Yes.
Get on your knees. Learn how to pray.
Yes.
And that's one thing I want these women to do, is to learn how to pray.
Mm-hmm.
Know how to come to God in prayer.
Yes.
Learn how to get on your knees and just ask God to let you to be able to relieve all of this pain that you've been through before. Ask him to help you get through, because there's no need to be ashamed of your pains, because God, God knows everything that you've been through.
Yes, everything. Yes, he does.
So even though that we're hiding all of this pain and all this trouble, sometimes it causes us to have medical issues holding on, because you have held on for so long that you're stressed out. We all been through things. I've been through things. Sometimes it's good to just talk to someone else that's been through themselves.
Amen.
Because if you talk to someone else that's been through the same problems that you've been through, it kind of give you a relief.
Yes, yes. And see, that's one of the things that tied us to one another, because we have that in common with being domestic abuse survivors. And when you have that in common and you tie that together, you find strength. You find strength.
Yes.
We went through that for somebody else. That was something that we didn't just go through just to go through. We survived it.
Yeah.
We survived it. And since we survived it, We survived it to pull somebody else out of the claws of the enemy, help them get through what they're going through, and to help them to know that just because they're in it doesn't mean that they have to stay there. Glory to God. Yes. So we have to understand that those that are here on here tonight, this is going to be a wonderful conference. If you're anywhere in North Carolina, in driving distance to Lewisburg, the information has hit the bottom of the screen. Meet us there this weekend. It starts tomorrow night and Saturday night. It is going to be phenomenal. The Lord has prepared me to bring forth a word on tomorrow night that will help set the captives free. Now, I want you to know about deliverance. Deliverance is something that it takes a process. There are some that can be delivered from things overnight. Come on here. But still, there may be still residue there. I want you to know that even though you get delivered, that we pray for you. There are some that can be delivered overnight, but there is a process to your breakthrough. There's some things that has been encapsulated in you for 10, 15, 20 years. And however long that is, sometimes it takes a while longer. That's why Pastor Carol said that once we pray for you, once you may go through a deliverance episode, but you have to be in place. You have to be plugged in. I am the senior pastor of the Power of Rhema Church in Durham, North Carolina. We meet on Sundays and Wednesdays, Sundays at 12 noon and Wednesdays at 7 p.m. You have to be plugged in. And then I do counseling upon appointments. Amen. Me and my husband, Apostle James Talley, he is my apostolic overseer. Pastor Carol, she and her husband, Pastor Nino Eckridge, they pastor in Lewisburg. Amen. Hallelujah. At the Healing Word Ministries at 845 at the Lewisburg College. Amen. So you have to understand that you have to be plugged in to a place in order to continue to feed your mind and feed your body, feed your spirit. Amen. The word of God, so that your deliverance can be wholly taken place. You don't want to just be delivered on Friday and then go back on Saturday and you in the same rut. No, it's a process. Somebody type, it's a process. It's a process. You have to go through this cycle of deliverance. Amen. I use this as an example. I got out of my first marriage. I was delivered out of my first marriage. I survived domestic abuse. Amen. I started... when I left that marriage of 7 years, amen, I was also in relationship with he was my high school sweetheart. I got my first black eye at 16, amen, which I hid it from my parents. I want you to know this, that you have to understand there was a process in order for me to break through. And through that process, I have a testimony. I left where I was afflicted at in that city and moved to Atlanta, 965 miles away, to even get my mind out of that arena so that I would not go back. Come on here. So there's a lot of us that cannot even deal with it locally. At that season, I didn't want to bring shame upon my parents because I was a PK. And so there was a lot of things that was attached to that because I never called the police on him. People knew that we fought. My friends knew that we fought. My sister knew that we fought. There were things that I kept from my parents. But even in the midst of that, I never called the police. Why? Because my oldest brother was a policeman. So I had a lot of things that were surrounding me and that was keeping me in bondage. And then when I was able to break free, when I broke free, I went to a backslidden state, amen, and thought that I would use anything, every man that I could, amen. So I went through a process, a cycle, my God, where the devil could have killed me, but God's grace kept me. So I want you to know that you got to get into a place where you cannot allow your present situation dictate your outcome.
Amen.
You can't allow that to be so, because see, in your presence, You can get out of what you're in if you're trapped into something. And they're not just not just domestic abuse, but there's a whole lot of different other things that women need to be delivered from. And men need to be delivered from, because we're not eliminating men. Amen. Not come to this conference. We want you to come too, because there's always room for deliverance for anybody. The Lord says that he will set the captives free. And I believe that there are some midwives. Amen. I'm a prophetic midwife and a mother in the gospel. So I know that I want to see women free. I have a passion for women. And this is the season where we need to come forward, and we need to step forward. If you're being abused by anybody, by you being abused by your husband, being abused by your parents' children, being abused by your pastor or your apostle or your bishop, yes, I'm coming right there, because a lot of you are hiding behind facades. You got on a mask, but you're masking your pain. I just heard the Lord saying you're masking your pain, and that's a dangerous situation. Go ahead and jump in, Pastor Carol.
And a lot of women too, I want to bring out an issue too. A lot of women, they're holding pain, not only with that, and like you brought out domestic violence, I've been through that myself. Mm-hmm. And a lot of women hold on pain of, too, I lost a child.
There it
and
is.
A lot of, they don't know how to cope. They don't know how to go on after losing a child. They're going through a depression state.
Yes.
Even though we're going through a depression state, we have to realize that God will still supply. We don't know if we'll never have another child again. Mm-hmm. But like I do, I had to keep on moving. It was a depression, and sometimes you think about it year after year, my child would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Wow.
But even though I lost my child, God, he still gave me a son.
Yes.
Someone to care about. So God replaced sometimes what we lose. But death is not easy.
No.
And some women, when they lose a child, they just go into a depressed state, and some don't even come out. We have to know that our mind, we have to keep our mind. Because sometimes we lose our mind when we go through all of these things. But we have to know one thing: God do not put more on us than what we can bear.
Amen. 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 And since he does not do that, he allows us to be able to, when we need help, I am a true believer that God will send help. At our lowest point, I'm telling you to look for a light. At the darkest point of my life, I looked up and saw a light. Somebody to help snatch me out of where I was at. To say,
yes,
you can live and not die and proclaim the works of the Lord. And I believe those that survive these type of attacks from the enemy, death of a child, rape, molestation, you know, domestic violence, the list goes on and on, abuse of any sort and any kind. I believe those ones that are survivors of that and can stand strong, your job is to pick a sister up. Your job is to pull a sister out. Your job is to help that daughter get her life together. And I believe that this is our season, that the women are to stand up, cry loud, and spare not. Go into the trenches, go into the highways and byways, compel the women of God to come out and not to allow their pain to keep them hidden, not to allow their pain to keep them in a cave, not to be afraid to step out and say, no longer will I deal with this. No longer will this have me bound. And I think that this is the season that we need to come together as women of God, not being jealous of anyone, not being jealous of each other, but just latching hold and saying, you know what, we need healing to go through the nation. We need healing to go through the deliverance to go through the nation, because abuse is not one sided, and it does not attack one ethnicity. Yes. It's not black, it's not white, it's no color. It attacks every color. I was listening to a broadcast on yesterday, the news. My husband brought it to my attention. Something came up on the news of that wasn't my husband. I was at an appointment today, and I was with another young lady, and who did my nail tech. And on the news came up a story of a husband and a wife, and the wife was Indian. I don't know if you saw this, but the mother, the mother of the girl, the couple, the husband and wife, I think they just had a newborn baby. The baby was newborn, and the mother of the child was pure-blooded Indian, and her mother took the authorities of the reservation to the hospital under some type of subpoena that they got from their court system on the reservation, and they took the baby because she lied and said that the mother, her daughter, was not going to be a good mother. So they took the baby.
Wow.
To the reservation, and since the reservation is Indian property, now the federal police are the only ones that can go onto the reservation and get this baby. And they've had this baby, I guess, several days. She just had the baby. They came up with some type of paperwork. I don't know how this hospital allowed this to happen, but they took that baby from this mother. Just had the baby. Now her milk is just still. She hasn't even been able to nurse this child. So my heart sank as I was watching this on the TV, because for the simple reason, now she has her body reacting to feeding and nursing her child, which the child is no longer there. Now she also has postpartum. Come on. So her mind is almost to a place of craziness. The husband is left with his hands tied, can't get his baby. It is on the reservation where they can't go to. And so they have petitioned the court system. And the only way that they can go and get this baby is the federal police are the only ones that can access and have the right to get on the reservation and take this baby. So they said to be continued. So it's all over the national news. I don't know if they've gotten on there today to get the baby, but the mother has fabricated this story to steal her child's baby, newborn baby, out of the hospital. I call it stealing because that's exactly what it was. I don't care what kind of paperwork it was. I don't know. I look at the hospital, they can just be ready for a big lawsuit. I can't even fathom how this happened. It's got to be something else to this story. So I looked at that. That is a form of abuse. And what are you saying, Pastor? What I'm saying is that type of abuse will mess with your mind. That type of abuse will mess with your psyche. That's something that's called emotional abuse. That's called emotional abuse. That's something that will take you out of here. That's something that will cause you to go into such a deep depression that you can't pull yourself up out of. You understand what I'm saying? So women are going through that today. I'm ministering to young women today, old women today, middle-aged women today, and they are going through some stuff that I have never thought that. I said, Lord, this enemy is crazy. If we don't take a stand to unite ourselves together, this cycle will continue until the Lord decides to come back here.
And it's sad because I used to work at women's prison. I worked in women's prison for 10 years. And when I worked in the women's prison system, you'll see so many women that will have kids. They come inside the prison pregnant, where they got in pregnant in the streets, and they serve the time in jail, and now it's time for them to do their real time. And they have the babies. After they have the babies, they want the drugs so bad, or whatever lifestyle, that they sign their child over to the state. Jesus. Going to be in that custody. And it's sad, because some of these women, they will get out of prison, 6 months later they're back in. It's like a cycle, like you said, it's a cycle. Soon as they get released, they're coming right back. And it's like that they don't want to be free. And one time I was talking to one of the inmates, and she told me, she said, it was just more what made her to really want to clean herself up. She said that she had a daughter. She took her daughter to school. She was on crack. And she said she was trying to walk her daughter to class, and her daughter was like, "Mommy, I don't even want you to walk me to class." And she was like, "Wow, I'm your mom." And she said, her daughter kept on saying, "Mom, I don't want you to walk me to class." So she said, she asked her daughter, she said, "Why don't you want me to walk?" She said, "Mommy, look how you look." She said when she went home, she looked in the mirror and she realized how raggedy she looked. And she saw how tore up that the crack had made her. And she said she began to be ashamed and she just cried. And she said that's the only thing that made her want to clean herself up. And if you just listen to some of their stories, it's sad. I mean, a lot of them come in because the way that they was raised at home, they didn't know any better. And a lot of them are looking for attention. A lot of them are in there falling behind their boyfriends because the boyfriends were selling drugs. They wanted to sell drugs, or they was just with them. And a lot of them were serving the boyfriend's time. You will be amazed at some of the stories that you will hear women tell you. Or if you're just even looking at their crime scenes to cover up for a man. This cycle has to stop. It got to stop somewhere. And it's sad.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. And I am in a place now where I am not going, I value my oil that is on my life. Not that it's even any greater than anybody else. I just value mine. I'm just hearing my heart here tonight. I know that we're live here on Facebook Live, and I want you to know that I'm not high-minded. I just know who I am in God, and I know what mine's cost me. It almost cost me my life 3 times. So I'm not going to spill my oil in places that is not needed. I know what I'm called to, and I know who I'm called to. And this is a part of my calling, is to help wounded women and men to get free. We're better than this. We're better than this. You're better than anything that the enemy tries to throw at us. We're better than that. And we have to expose him. And once we expose him, we can move forward and we can take the devil's clutches off of the women and the men of God and let them know he came so that you would be set free, period.
Amen.
And I'm here to labor with you until you get free. Not just on Friday night, not just on Saturday night, but if you want to get free, you got to put in the work.
Continually,
because, you know, I work out continually because I want to remain healthy. I can't just go one day and expect to get all of the benefits of somebody who's working out 5 days a week or 3 times a week, and I only go one day a month. No, I got to put in the work. And so that's what we are empowering them to, is to put in the work. And that's a whole different discussion. It's just putting in the work. And I don't believe that this is something that we can continue to just throw out, you know, a women's conference here, a women's conference here. When you call it forth a deliverance conference, it's one for women, healing for those ones that need to come. It can't happen just once a year. It has to be a cycle that we can go on and continue and say, you know what, you're in Lewisburg, I'm in Durham. Those that can't get to Lewisburg, then I got the breach. I just heard the Lord say I got the birth one in Durham so that they can come in and get free. Not just, you know what, come in and we can wear our pretty clothes and we can do this and we can do that. No, we need somebody that's going to labor with us at the altar. Will you pray with me? Will we be able to lay down on the floor? There's nothing that I can't wear that I can't lay down on the floor and get you help you deliver. If you're crying, I'm not going to be like, oh, you can't cry on my shirt or you can't. No. We need people that are real. We need people that are going to be able to say, you know what, I'm going into the trenches with you. I'm going to lay down with you. I'm going to help you get free right here, right now. You know, if it takes us this long, but then we're going to be here this long. You understand what I'm saying? And then we can plug them into a place where they can go, amen, and continue to get free. Because like we said, this is a process. This is a process. It's a process to your breakthrough. It has to be a process. Because this emotional damage is sometimes greater than a punch. Yes. If I could have broke free from the emotional attachment, you understand? Because I could forgive the punch, but it was the emotional attachment that I had that kept me there. And we got to understand it can survive this because, you know, just like we just prayed for Pastor Lambert and his family, you know, that couple that killed that 4-year-old child. My heart aches. I don't blame it on him. I don't blame it on her. It's both of them now. It's both of them now that are getting ready to hurt. It's both of them now that lives are over. Come on here. Their child's life is over, and now their life is over. And we know what they do to people, like, you know, who hurt children in prison. You know that. You worked in the prison, just like you said. And that's a dangerous thing right there, you know, when you kill a child. The Bible says suffer the little children. My God. Yes. So where are we at in all of this when we can have a 20-year-old smoking, puffing off of a joint? Where are we at? Where was her mind at besides her being high too? Because
innocent babies.
Yeah. Because I've been high before, but I ain't never been that high where I want to give my child something. Come on, yeah. Reprobated minds are taking place now, and we need to be able to, woo, as women of God.
And you know, show that I had to watch it like 5 times.
Right.
It hurt my heart. It hurt my heart. And I just couldn't believe it, you know. And it seemed like it kind of affected me because I just couldn't believe that an innocent 1-year-old baby inhaling and the way that the baby blew the smoke, it's like the baby was used to it. Like this wasn't this child's first time doing this.
It wasn't the first time. You caught
and
that.
It hurts. It hurts to see our young kids doing the things that they're doing. They're lost. We're living in a time where kids are lost, the society is lost. It's time to start speaking up. And some women, they don't have a good role model in their life.
No, they don't.
And it's not a shame just to come out to this conference and to pray for your problems. Nobody's not going to turn their nose up at you. Nobody's not going to look at you snobby any kind of way. Because guess what? We was young. We was older. We made mistakes. We asked God to forgive us. But we had to learn to continue to break the cycle and to not go back to those things. That's what, when you start praying, you got to continue. It's not going to be an overnight process, but you have to motivate yourself to do it. And it's hurtful when a mother that really loves their child is really trying to raise the child the best way to see their child wander off and to see their child hurt. And for it to hurt me to not even to know this young lady.
Yes.
Because only if maybe if the right person would have reached out to her, maybe she would have wanted to change. Mm-hmm. But even when I watched her in court today, I said, thank God that she did show some emotion, that she did cry.
Okay.
Because it made her later, maybe when she came down to her high,
yeah,
maybe it made her realize, why did I do such crazy?
Yeah. Yeah.
And see, sometimes when women do stuff, it's too late.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's too late. Because it's after the fact now. And I just, however, you know, if we can just reach out to one person.
Yes,
to
yes.
help someone. To break these cycles. Because the chain has to be broken somewhere.
Yes.
Somewhere.
Yes. Somewhere. And that's what I'm saying. You know, I'm not coming for the masses tomorrow night. If God give it to us for salvation, that's fine. But I'm coming for the one. If we can help one. If we can bless one. If we can pull one out of darkness and let them know that Jesus loves you. In spite of who you are. In spite of your background. In spite of your makeup. In spite of your generational things that have gone on in your bloodline. In spite of all of that. I don't care if it's just one that we can reach, then heaven is rejoicing. Yes. I believe that tomorrow night is going to be an awesome night. Those that need to get to Free Salvation Church, 419 Fox Park Road, Lewisburg, North Carolina, at 7 p.m. tomorrow night and Saturday night. Amen. Where Healing Word Ministries will be having their annual women's conference. The title is Deliverance, and I'm telling you, God has changed my word, and I got a word from the Lord. Amen. And I do believe that there are going to be some women and men that are going to get set free tomorrow night and Saturday night. And I believe that this is an hour where we have to let people know that, you know what, we're not afraid of the devil. And you know what, just as you said, that, you know what, it may have been too late for what you have been through and you may have to pay for it, but it's not too late for God to save your soul and to save your life and for you to have eternal life. So I'm telling you that this is going to be a powerful conference. I've been basking in the presence of the Lord for about 6 hours today. Amen. Laying down, waking up, thinking and say, okay, God, what now? You know, and just really meditating. I get quiet when it's time to minister. This is something serious to me when it comes down to people's lives that are weighing in the balance. It's just the third month of the year.
Yes.
And there is so much crying. There is so much hurt. There is so much pain. There are so many children that have already died. There are so many women that have already died. There are so many men that have already died. There are so many children that have already committed suicide. Let's talk about that. I read the article yesterday, and then I read it in its entirety today, of the 9-year-old black daughter, African-American daughter, that committed suicide.
Yes, being bullied.
Being bullied in school. Bring your children to this conference because you're going to be surprised that there are some that you have not listened to. The father said that he wished that he would have not ignored the signs. He said she would come home and she would say, I don't want to go to school. She would call home from school and say, I have a headache. I have a stomach ache. Mama, daddy, can you come and get me? And they would say, you're going to be all right. It's okay. And then when she would come home, she would kind of seclude herself. And they would say, why? She was like, I don't want to go back to school. And so this Am I back? Okay, I just got a call. I'm sorry. I'm glad that didn't go off. This particular day, it was morning time, and he sent or evening time, and he sent her brother upstairs. He said, "Go upstairs and tell your sister to come downstairs and eat." And he went upstairs and he came back down and he said, "Daddy, Sissy's playing a prank. She won't wake up." And so he said, "Okay." So he went upstairs and he went into his baby's room, his 9-year-old daughter's room, and found her hanging from a belt, a homemade noose from her bunk bed. But it was too late. 9 years old.
That's
cool. 9 years old. At 9 years old, I was still playing with baby dolls. I wasn't being bullied in school. I remember people saying some things to me because different things, you know, saying different things to me in school, you know, boys teasing and things like that. But these were girls that were teasing her. I mean, telling her how ugly she was and saying things about her. But can you imagine what he felt seeing his 9-year-old baby hanging from a belt? And now he's in a place where saying, "I wish I would have listened." And he said there were times when he said, "Well, do you want me to go to school?" And he said he never reported it because she said, "If you report it, then they're going to talk about me more." But then he said, "You know what? Even the school didn't even tell me anything was happening because it was never reported during school." You mean to tell me that there was no teacher that heard these children ridiculing this girl? I can't. No teacher's aid, no lunch aid, no. And, you know, really, a lot of African-American families, you know, children, they don't commit suicide. They might, you know, do drugs and things like that. But this is something. This lets us know that the devil is coming right at us. And if he can't get to you,
he's busy.
If he can't get to the parents, he's coming after our children. And we have to listen to their cry of help. That's right, Veronica. We got to listen to their cry of help. So I think this is a very important conference. I thank God for you that you came on tonight to talk a little bit about your conference. I'm excited that you have me come in to speak and open up your conference for you. I'm excited about what God is going to do and how the people of God will be blessed from the praise and worship all the way down to the preached word. And then I am just so excited about the ones that will be delivered on tomorrow night and on Saturday this weekend. I am really expecting a mighty, mighty move of God. And I know that God will and God can do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. So I'm asking each and every one of you that are listening to us that you would share this broadcast, that you would tag somebody in this broadcast on your Facebook wall, amen, so that it would get onto your timeline. We need your help in advertising this conference. We already have so many people that said that they will be coming, but we know that this is a time and it's a need for each person, amen, to get delivered that needs to be healed or delivered. We're going to have our altars open. We're going to be praying. I'm going to be laying hands. I already know that we're going to be going to war, amen, against the enemy. And I do believe that, you know what? We're going into the enemy's camp and we're going to take back and declare what he's stolen from the Lord, amen. And so your soul is important. If there's anybody in your family that needs prayer, special prayer, healing and deliverance prayer, amen, we need you to get them to this conference on tomorrow night. Again, it's at Free Salvation Church Healing Word Ministries. It's the host of this, Pastor Carol Eckridge. 419 Fox Park Road, Lewisburg, North Carolina, tomorrow at 7 p.m. and on Saturday night at 7 p.m. So if you miss tomorrow night, you need to get there on Saturday night. Amen. It is going to be awesome. It's going to be phenomenal. We're going to see the wind of God blow through that place like never before. This is the month of miracles. This is March. And we are marching, hallelujah, unto the Resurrection Sunday and then to Pentecost. Hallelujah. How many know when it's this season, signs and wonders and miracles follow them that believe God? And I don't know about you, but I need a miracle. And I know you need a miracle. And there are people out here that need a miracle. And there are people out here that need a lifeline thrown to them to let them know that, you know what? We stand, hallelujah, for the Lord. And we are not afraid of the devil. We're coming right at him. And we're getting ready to snatch some people out of hell from where they are. In the name of Jesus. I do believe that God is still God. And I said before, I don't serve a dead God. I serve a risen Savior. And hallelujah, I know that he, glory to God, is getting ready to be glorified. Amen. On tomorrow evening and on Saturday during this conference, we glorify the Lord. Amen. And we're going to, amen, do exactly what he has called us to do. Nothing about what we do, but it's all about what he does. Amen. And we're going to work the work while it's day. Because if we work the work while it's day, we know that the Bible says that night cometh. And we don't want to get caught at night. Amen. Because we want to do what he has called us to do. He saved our lives for this reason. He saved our souls for this reason. And this is the season for their women and men of God that need to be pulled out of where they've been placed into. And that is in the captivity of the enemy. He said he came so that we would have life and life more abundantly. And so today we thank God for you. I thank God for you, daughter. Amen. I thank God for each and every one of you, amen, that have come in and taken some time tonight to just stop in and hear what we have to say. We pray that we see you on tomorrow night. We pray that you be blessed and you bring somebody, if not tomorrow night, that you will bring somebody on Saturday night at 7 o'clock, amen. The information is all on my Facebook wall. It's all on Pastor Carol's wall. We expect you to be there. We expect you to be praying for us. If you can't be there, amen, pray for some souls to be saved in Jesus' name. So God bless you. May he keep you. I love you, daughter. I will see you on tomorrow.
Amen, amen. That was Senior Pastor Tina Talley interviewing Co-Pastor Carol Ackridge of Healing Word Ministries, talking about the women conference that starts on Friday, which is tomorrow at 7 p.m. at Free Salvation Holiness Church, Fox Park Road. That's 419 Fox Park Road, Lewisburg, North Carolina, 27549. Amen. We're looking for a great time, and I know you've already heard it. If you're just tuning in, you can go back and listen to the interview and the whole entire thing as once we finish. But I'm telling you right now, we just excited about what God is going to do. I'm just got to go with an expectation that he's going to deliver. He's going to set free. Hey, man, the shackle's going to fall off, and we're going to just be praising him, hallelujah, for people's lives. Amen. You know, that's what we ought to be doing. You know, we ought to be excited when change comes in somebody else's life, when somebody else gets saved, when somebody give their life to God. Amen. We ought to be praising God and thanking him and cheering, hallelujah, amen, for those brothers and sisters. Now they are once was lost, but now found. Glory be to God. Amen. We're going to continue to broadcast. Amen. And we'll be right back with more, so stay tuned.
See, the problem is you just want to have the juice. You just wanna be cool, be down with the crew. The only one that had your back. When you came to me, I put you back on track, but you played me. I turned my back, put a blade in me. Why you gotta act so shady?
I just wanted you to be my baby, yeah. I wanted to be your only one. I wanna do the 1+1. Why you gotta ask so shady? I just wanted you to be my baby, yeah. I wanted to be your only one. I wanna do the 1+1. I'ma say bye to the lies and let it fly away. You gon' say I was right when you cry, I'ma fade away. I'ma say bye to the lies and let it fly away. You gon' say I was right when you cry, I'ma fade away. From the lies, the disguise, you took me by surprise. From the lies, things you hide, the things you set aside. Check up, I'm the real one, I'm next up. You could've been messing with a winner, taking you to Paris in the winter, but you played me. I turned my back, put a blade in me. From the lies, the disguise, you took me by surprise. Girl, you played me. I turned my back, put a blade in me. From the lies, the disguise, the things you set aside. Why you gotta act so shady? I just wanted you to be my baby, yeah. I wanted to be your only one. I wanna do the 1+1. Why you gotta act so shady? I just wanted you to be my baby, yeah. I wanted to be your only one. I wanna do the 1+1. Think back to when you played me like a fool. You thought it was cool. I'm on a whole other level making moves. Think back to when I was nothing to you. You ain't even think I was cool. Now I can't even get you to move. Look at me now, look at me now. I'm brand new. I switched up. Tell me what you wanna do. Do you wanna do the 1+1? 1+1 = 2. 1+1 = you. Do you wanna do the 1+1? 1+1 = 2. 1+1 = you.
I don't know about you, but are you ready? Are you ready for this weekend, a powerful weekend of deliverance, of healing, amen, of praying, of a word from God? Are you ready, women and men? Men, you are welcome to come to this women's conference, March 23rd and March 24th, 7 o'clock p.m., and the location will be at 419 Fox Park Road, Lewisburg, North Carolina, 27549, at the Free Salvation Holiness Church. Amen. Healing Word Ministries, first annual women's conference, and we're just going to believe God is going to touch, amen, that place like never before. And we've already had a powerful packed Sunday, amen, at Hickory Grove. My God, what a move of God was in that house. Amen. And we thank God for what took place on Sunday, and we just know that it's going to carry over to Friday and Saturday night. So we just thankful, amen, everybody be in place, amen, that we have a great time in the Lord with one another, uplifting the name of Jesus, amen. I tell you, whoo, Thursday night music mix, amen. Yours truly, Pastor Nino Ackridge, your host. Let's keep cooking with grease, baby.
Come on, we worshiping all night tonight, so I hope you're comfortable. Come on, let me hear you. Pain away. I'm so in love with you. You make me happy. You make me whole. You take the pain away. I'm so in love with you. Come on, say that with us. You make me happy. Come on, say you make me whole. That's it. Say you take the pain away. Now tell him I'm so in love with you. Let's do it again. Say you make me happy.
You.
Everything about you is also right. That's right. I'm telling you, we had an awesome night tonight listening in to the interview. Senior Pastor Tina Talley, which will be our speaker for Friday night for our Healing Word Ministries first annual women's conference. And also my wife, co-pastor Carol Ackridge, amen, on the women. And just a wonderful interview talking about, you know, the problems and the issues that not only women but men endure and go through. So we are looking for an awesome time on tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, y'all. So please, sir, please, ma'am, share this broadcast, tell the people to listen in, and also visit us, come to this conference, amen, come for this conference both nights, amen, to just hear word from the Lord and just pray for your brothers and sisters, amen. So we thank God again for you listeners that tune in each and every week. We thank God for all of you, and we want you to have a blessed and a fantastic day on tomorrow. But most of all, continue to love, share that love, and continue to walk in Christ. Amen. We love you with the love of the Lord. Until next time, we want you to be blessed.
Yeah. body doesn't want to say it, but my soul says, yeah. My spirit says, yeah. Lord, I'm going to say, yeah. 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 Yeah.